what sand means to me is it's the earth. And I interpret with the sand what I feel as far as my place on this earth, also my place in the universe.
Navajo sand paintings that are done for ritualistic purposes or ceremonies. So as I grew older, I began to realize these paintings are for short periods of time. I went to school or was exposed to Western life, and then I've seen paintings that were supposed to last forever. So there's a big difference between these types of paintings. The thrill and the joy of seeing a painting that is done for only a certain amount of time or for that purpose in that time, just like a song or a note, only for that moment, ephemeral work. So in my world, who I am as a Navajo, as Joe Ben, I live in both worlds.
The collection of pigments range from here in the Southwest to Europe. So my pigments basically tells a story about my travel. The pigments that I collect range from clay to semi-precious stone to precious stone as far as like diamond, metal, gold. Sometimes I use silver. So the material, the pigments, come from a wide variety of sources, but naturally colored material, and again, through natural processes.
This painting is called Morning Offering with Blue Corn Lady. And this talks about dawn and how the transition and the beginning or the end of the day is at this time, not as midnight as we go by Western time concept. So what it addresses is just to talk about at this time, this special time. I can go outside in the morning at this time and give my offering with corn pollen and hear the birds chirping at a specific time at dawn. I can look at flowers, and they will turn just that direction also, and just do as I do, and open their arms to the sun. Open their arms to the dawn, and to these rays, to the Shun Din, this is what it's called. Hayos Kaf Shun Din. And also the pigments, like for example here, what I did, when I got it in my hand, I crushed it, and I just let it go. And went poof. Before it gets on that surface and that support, it comes directly from my fingers and onto that. There's no tools getting in the way here. What I want the people, the audience, to see in my work is basically themselves. Maybe it's some parts of themselves that they don't see or feel or understand. Maybe just to provoke some feelings and provoke some understanding of one's needs. And once they see that, they begin to see their lives, they begin to see their community, and also to see me and my community, and begin to see the kinship between people and places and time.
One of the things that's most important, I feel, in my work is to express the richness of America, the richness that has been here before, beyond 300 or 400 years ago. I think what Phoenix serves for me as a Navajo who is an indigenous person is to live in a foreign country, meaning I'm using foreign currency, foreign way of life, foreign concept, and foreign language. And for this reason, it's quite easy for me because Phoenix becomes like a stepping stone. So from there, from Phoenix, I'm able to work throughout the world. What I bring to Phoenix is some truth and honesty. Some truth and honesty about who I am as, number one, as a Navajo, number two, as an indigenous person, number three, as an American.